Greetings for the Ulkins, welcome back to more Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. It has been a while since I uploaded my last video, but yeah, here's to hoping I'm more consistent. I actually moved houses, so that came along with a lifestyle change and consequent adjustment to a great degree. So yeah, one of the things that I realized about Daggerfall is that this isn't exactly a game that you can just, you know, pick up, complete the main quest line and get done with. There is quite a lot of roleplay involved, and the way to play this game is by completely immersing yourself into it. Unless you want to, you know, keep opening up the Elder Scrolls pages to refer to every single thing that you have to do. So that being said, I also did some research on the letter from, or rather the summons from the Underking, and as it turns out, wait, that wasn't the Underking, that was, I think, the King of Worms, yes. So yeah, apparently that's like a pretty high level quest. Technically I am suited to it, but I would rather not do that right now since I am level 7 and that is a quest meant for level 7 players. So what I'm going to do first in this place, where there will come a point in time when I'll have to decide who to give a powerful artifact to, and apparently I need my reputation with them to be higher in order to achieve that. So what I've decided is that for this place where I'm going to give the artifact to, well, the Kingdom of Daggerfall, and as a result, what I would instead like to do is, well, basically just go over to Daggerfall and increase my reputation there through side quests. So we'll just shelf the King of Worms quest for now, and we'll travel over to Daggerfall and see what we can do there. So yeah, see you guys there. A page girl bearing the quest of Sentinels stiffly presents to you a crisply pressed envelope. Ignoring your queries, she turns and walks away. Okay, I guess we shall be reading that as well. Emperor's Shielding, right. This is the shop that we wanted. The time right now is 8:59. We can stand outside and read the letter. Wow. This thing takes its course. So, yeah. So, basically the letter... Of course, I'm gonna have to use this. Dear Grimfangs, your presence is our court is desired before the end of the next season. Prince Luton has recommended you with high praise. I await your arrival. Akorati, Queen of Sentinel. Okay, this is unfamiliar to me. I don't know why she's summoning me, you know. Maybe for a mission, but I don't think I've read up about this. Maybe it could be like one of those optional missions. I think it involved some sort of a painting, if I'm not wrong. But then again, I don't exactly want to spoil the thing for the rest of you, so yeah. See you first. If you are available for hire, I need someone reliable to carry out a certain covert mission. It might be rather time consuming, but I assure you that you will be suitably compensated. Are you interested? Yes, yes I am. Very good, I'm giving you an emerald for you to give my contact, Euthane Hopton of Tunwall Borough. He will be waiting in the Hopton residence. The item needs to be there in 5 days. That's very important. Once you've made it that far, Euthane Hopton will have further instructions. I'm counting on your discretion, Grimfangs, and you will be watched. Good luck and thank you. Okay, I will be watched. If she can spare people to, you know, watch me with the diamond, or rather, yeah, emerald, then why is she not arranging the delivery herself? Is this like some sort of a test? Yeah, Turnwall Burrow, that is where we will go, I suppose. These next few videos might be a little boring, but as far as Daggerfall is concerned, you really need to go about and well, roleplay about, and I suppose these are the kinds of videos which are better suited for streaming. Like these games, like the Elder Scrolls games, start Daggerfall and Daggerfall onwards, and not precisely Daggerfall onwards either, because Dunwall Burrow, I think. Yep, right there. 2 days of travel time, 3 days of travel time. Yeah, that's okay. What's the time right now? 6:10 this morning. That's fine. Plus, I don't think there is much problem. You know. Hockton residence, of course, the Hockton residence. Let me go ahead and ask you where the Hockton residence is. Why are you two guys inside each other? Okay. Painting. Ah, it is the painting quest line. Wait, is it? I think it is. I think that's the quest line that I got the letter for. But anyway, what did I say? I completely forgot what I was saying. That tends to happen to me quite a lot. General, I suppose? Best destination to any news. Regional? No, location. I want the Lutheran Hockton, okay. We'll try to just keep going best. Okay. That would be this direction, I suppose. I don't think this place is so large that I might need a, you know, horse to traverse it either. Yeah, but like Arena had thieves during the night. I don't think I've ever seen a thief in the dead of the night here in Daggerfall, but I am also quite certain that that is a strange shell. Are you Barbados? Well, you bark. Nice. You look a little aggressive, if you don't mind me saying that. What just happened here? The thieves' guild has word that you're carrying a gemstone of considerable value. Hand it over and I'll let you off easy. Absolutely not. You can, you know, happily die. Thank you. I'm glad that, like just as I was about to say that, you know, I haven't seen any thieves that assault you in the dead of the night. I got assaulted by one, even though, I mean, this is part of the questline. But, yeah, I don't think I've ever seen any, you know, thieves assaulting us in the middle of the night. It's just in Daggerfall that it's a problem. Like, Daggerfall. Because the ghost of Lysandus apparently haunts the city, and if you stay out in the night, he will try to kill you. And back then I got first assaulted by the ghost of the king. I didn't even have like a potion free action, and I just kept getting paralyzed over and over again. I might as well ask somebody about the whereabouts of this person. Somewhere west of here, okay. Still west? I'll keep going west then, I suppose. This is clearly an inn. The Crimson Chin. Residence. Now, right now I am looking to curry favor with the province of Wayrest, but that is only because I have decided to, well, the links on the map. I have decided to, like, be a friend to the Emperor, since that is what the Emperor called me at the very beginning of this game, and give the artifact to one of his friends, since I can't exactly go to the Emperor himself. So, yeah, that's the entire reason why I've decided to curry favor with Daggerfall. Not Daggerfall, right, Wayrest. Or rather, Castle Wayrest. So, anyway, let me just go ahead and ask you, do you know where this person is? Very helpful, sir, thank you very much. You there. Gonna be somewhere around here. I wonder if that person did not have. I wonder if that thief had like some sort of a note with him or something. That would actually tell me the location of Lutheran Hockton. You'll find that the Hockton residence is northwest of here. But that's the entire thing that I've been trying to like figure out. Like, where is the Hopton residence? Like, I've got no idea where that is. General, see, the general list is empty, so yeah, I mean, I've got no idea where the Hopton residence is, but anyway. That was convenient, but yeah, I'll just ask you as well. People you can hop to. Northwest, of course. Northwest. This direction? Okay. Oh, this is it. Right, size that's. Okay. The Hopton residence, you can hop to. Are you can hop to? Nope. Baron Kingvin? Kingvin? It's Ver Kingvin. You look like a Yuthian Hopton? Yes, you are. Why is it that the quest givers are always, or you know, people born into quest lines are always these generic characters? Ah, good. The last carrier Queen Barenziah hired never found me, and we had to hunt him down. Most unpleasant. Here's the agrotat. It goes to Perard Gearing, this well-to-do merchant in Fontwell Heath. You need to get it there in 7 days. Good luck, Grimfangs. Okay, Fontwell Heath. Fontwell Heath. Right, so this is sort of like a chain delivery quest. I don't exactly know what's going on here, and I won't pretend to know, but it seems to be some sort of a... Wait, where did I come in from? Very strange indeed. I see. So Fontwell Heath, it seems to be some sort of a very encrypted transmission of messages, I suppose. Or, because the last time I've seen something like this, it involved, selling contraband, or rather distributing contraband. But I won't go into too much depth regarding that. I plead the fifth on that. Fontwell Heath. Even though India does not have a Fifth Amendment, travel time would be 3 days, and I've got 7 days, so 4 days left to spare. 6:10. So let me just go ahead and I'll equip myself in case. Just want to eat. No pestilence or plague here as well. Daggerfall. Wayrest seems to be a nice place. General. Nope. I would just like to know about Perard Gearing. Okay. Location people. Yeah. Okay. Thank you for trying it nonetheless, I suppose. Hi there. People. Perard Gearing. Keep going east. Right. Why do I hear a horse? Oh. I was just about to drink out a horse, and then I heard the horse, and I was wondering why I hear the horse. Then I realized there are horses around me, that's why. So... Wait, so... No? Gearing residence, right. Of course. I mean, I have to go to his home, so yeah. This is just residence. House for sale. It's strange. I mean, I haven't really explored this option much, but I don't think you can purchase a house in Daggerfall. Then again, I mean, you just might be able to, who knows, right? It is, again, just the residence. I think this is an inn. Nope. This is nothing, apparently. This is also nothing. This is also nothing. And this is definitely also nothing. Just another residence. And we have reached the end of the line. Hi there. Can I talk to you for a second, please? Oh, that was loud. Okay, thank you for trying to help. You there. The one I'm standing on right now. Somewhere, just keep going southwest, I see. So instead of east, now I need to go southwest in this direction. The Gaelic residences. Well, these residences don't have any names, so leave them the skull. Laughing Dragon. I'm just doing that to mark them on my map, even though I'm probably never gonna come back here. But yeah. Moe and the Goblin. Now, one of the things about Daggerfall which sort of saddens me is how there was so much planned for this game, but they had to quash all of it just because of, you know, the release dates. And like, they were planning on releasing it too early, so. And they couldn't just make all the features in time, so they just went ahead and quashed all of those fine features. And that really bothers me. Like, I wish they would have implemented all of these features, but it would have become like a role-playing game of epic proportions, even today, to be honest. But yeah, they never could, you know, implement half of the stuff that they did, that they had planned on doing. And as a result, we have like a sort of incomplete game, which actually does not feel incomplete when you Emperor's Elixir, so okay. When you play it, but once you get to find out the entire scope of, I mean, you'll see minor discrepancies here and there, this is the place, every now and then, but it isn't until the time that you actually begin, you know, doing, assuming you're grabbing, yeah, doing a little bit of research that you finally realize how big of a scale the creators of Daggerfall imagined that the game would actually accomplish, but in the end it fell flat primarily because of, you know, release deadlines and things of that nature. So despite multiple delays at that, I just wish they would have taken the time and released it like 3 or 4 years later, even just to, you know, make the game meet their vision. But I suppose the practical side of things is that they had to capitalize on the success of the previous title, Arena, to make sales, and they couldn't exactly keep stretching it out like that. Ah, good to see you, Grimfangs. And the Aggro tab too. Excellent, and here is a 432 gold reward for your effort, and I might add, for your discretion. My name will not be forgotten. Sorry, your name will not be forgotten. Okay, so basically you don't have anything else you can do? That's it? Okay. My cousin, at Victor Yeoming, has appealed to me for aid in a rather distasteful situation. It appears that there is a temple of some variety being consecrated. If that's the proper phrase for these disgusting orcish activities, well, obviously we need to crush it while it's budding. I'm willing to give go as high as 565 gold. Can I count on your help, Grimfangs? Thank you in advance for this, Grimfangs. What I think would be the best use of your abilities is to infiltrate the ruins of Kingheart Manor and eliminate the so-called shaman of the temple. If we can kill it before our assault in 14 days, that would make our job much easier. When the deal is done, report to my cousin's palace in Tunmont. He's the one who's going to pay you for all this. Alright, so I suppose this is the last quest that I will take, and this seems to be a dungeon, you know, a type of quest. So, yeah, let's go. Let's take another mission from Queen Barenziah and Surfer. Now, where did we want to go again? Pretty cloudy day, if you ask me. Ruins of Kingheart Manor. Okay. I think I had a typo in there. Now I have 10 days, a heap of rusting shovels. Now here's the thing, I want to use the Dwarven Axe right now, But if perchance I'm unable to use it for whatever reason, for whatsoever reason, then I'll just... move over to using other stuff instead. I do have a lot of weapons, and I don't think I have a shortage of any weapons per se. One of the things that I would like to do is equip this, since yeah. So I'm just gonna go ahead and explore this area a little. Right hand equipped. Should be somewhere over here. It's typically in here, but where is the entrance? I'm just gonna look for the entrance, and then we'll be on our way. Is that it? I suppose it is. I'm supposed to go a shaman of sorts and return to a different person who will be paying me for my troubles. So, yeah. Okay, let's get this done. Oh, hi there. I don't know if you're the shaman. No, you're just a thief. Just a regular thief. I'll just take this from you and... I wonder what that sound is. I think the sound just bugged out, being the reason why I'm hearing all those noises in my headphones. Oh, that's a beer. Hi. Grizzly just died. I'm more tired than I am, you know, like, okay, we're going deeper now. That is an underwater section. I really do hope that I'm not at home, but not that I hope, not that it would pose, like, much of a problem for me, but, yeah. Did somebody assault me with an arrow? I thought I heard that. Hey, Skelly! You're surprisingly difficult to kill. Skeletal warrior, is that like something different? There's also some clothes here, so yeah, let's take those. Everything's going well thus far, so let me just go ahead and save the game here. Yeah, I'm not going down in the underwater section. Although I suppose I can at this point, but I'll reserve that area for later. Like, for the very end. I don't want to go down there right now. This dungeon seems to be straightforward for the time being. And I think a lot of the dungeons in this game are just about familiarizing yourself with all the modules that there are nightly. Fuck you. I mean, shocking me like that out of the blue. Edgar. I don't even have 76 gold pieces. Chain boots. Nothing of interest to me. This does look radical, but I have got elven ball rods, which are significantly better. So, nothing of use there. This goes up. Let's just check this out. Why don't we? Well, they're at it, I mean. Like, that guy just came out of nowhere, honestly. I suppose there's nothing here? Yeah, there isn't. Both of these parts go up, so... tell you what. Actually, that doesn't make sense. This is the same corridor, so might as well just go through here. In that case. Okay. Hey, bear. I'm actually using the axe in order to increase my axe skill. Oh, hi there. I think somebody's here. Just a minute. So, it has actually been a while since I last played this game, and I completely forgot that you actually have to rest inside dungeons and keep saving. Because I was just about to die back there, if you guys, I don't know whether you guys noticed or not. This seems to be an entirely different section of the map, so I'll leave this for later. I'll come back here. This also goes upstairs, so I'll leave this as well for later. I'll come back here too. I'll come back here as well, rather. Oh, hi there, Orc. These guys hit hard. I mean, if there's anything about these orcs, they hit hard. Now, here's the thing. While I would love to take these pieces and sell them for gold, I don't know whether I have the bandwidth for that. Because, let me just go ahead and compare funds. I think my encumbrance is at 133. So I suppose I could take this Thai katana. Not. Equip it, but rather just sell it. And yeah, I'll come back here later as well, because again I see level changes. I want to more or less just at least finish this level or the levels up top before proceeding at all on with this here. Before going back down, so yeah, that. I suppose I'll go up for now, unless there are some secret doors or passageways here. What was on the right though, I think? The path on the right will get me on the same level. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, a skeleton. Of course, yeah. These guys make the most horrible, horrible of noises. I've never figured out why. For the time being, nah, I'm gonna improve my axe build, so I'll stick to the axe for now. Anything here? I don't think I see any shamans here. I'll let this space be here. And why can I not? Oh yeah, I need to grab wood. So this is nothing. I find that a little hard to believe. I guess it's just blocked off then. Unless it's opened by some other mechanism here. The straw scrape? You know what would suck if like the shaman was behind one of these things here and we actually had to open the door to actually get to them. Oh yeah, I think this also goes to the same level, so let's check this out as well. Was that the growl of a bear? A bear? Because yeah, that sounded nasty to be honest. Particularly nasty. I'll just rest him from the heat and then I'll save the game. This is an opportunity for me to go upstairs, so I'll take this opportunity. I'm trying to clear all levels, you know, procedurally, in a manner that I don't change levels until I'm missing. I have seemingly fully explored one level. Where the fuck did you go? Nightblade. He morphed through the. Ball there. This guy. Steel curse, it looks gorgeous. I mean, wow. Steel looks the prettiest among all of the other items in the game, but yeah. Not exactly what I'm looking for right now. That's it with this level, at least. And yeah, after that, we go downstairs, go back downstairs. I guess I'll go back downstairs. If I have to go back downstairs, then we might as well go back downstairs through this route. It may lead us to some other section of the castle. Or the ruins, rather. Not the castle. And we go back up. I wonder if this is the only thing there is. Like a resting spot, a safe haven. I'm going to use this opportunity to rest. One of the things that I like about this dungeon is that there are lots of places for us to rest. So, like, it doesn't shower you with constant encounters and enemies all around. It gives you plenty of chances to rest, and I like that. I like that for a dungeon. More dungeons should have, features like that, where you can rest as much as you want to. I guess I'll try going upstairs from the other favour. I'm deliberately moving slowly to preserve my stamina. I'm pretty sure that if I got an enchantment that would speed me up, or naturally in response to my speed, I would be walking faster, but for now I just want to preserve my stamina. Hi there, thief, I'm guessing? Yeah, look like one. I sort of feel bad taking these people's salaries from them, but No, did he like kill a puppy or something? How could she? That's horrible. I thought I was making those sounds. Tell half the times whether these are just audio glitches or like actual things in the game, occurrences in the game. But some of them are downright creepy. I mean, just look at that sound. I mean, out of nowhere, just assaults your ears out of nowhere. Creepy, if you ask me. Very creepy. So there isn't really much in this level, apparently. I think this also took us downstairs. No, this was nothing. Shaman, where's the shaman? Oh yeah, there's another path to the upstairs here. Skeletor. That sounds horrible. I mean, all skeletons do, so... I'll just keep this in my inventory as well. How much space do I have to carry stuff? I wonder. Yeah, I can still carry quite a lot of weight, apparently. Apparently this game also has a mechanic where if you're wearing heavy armor or your encumbrance is high, you pretty much just automatically drown, no matter your swimming skill. So, I mean not drown, but it sinks to the bottom. So, yeah. Like, you need low encumbrance to be able to swim in this game. From what I gather anyway. Strange. Long, narrow pathway leading nowhere, but to no skeletons. Did this guy just feel like there were two attacks in a row? I think it did. There's a bear, a grizzly. Oh, hi there. So I've got this tunnel with the grizzly here, which I've not explored yet. This round thingy. This lock has nothing to fear for me. I will equip my axe while I take on this lock. This will apparently help me improve my hand-to-hand skill. Apparently the kick has more range as well, which is curious. Quite curious. So yeah, this I read this tip on Reddit. Apparently this helps you, well, preserve the sanctity of your weapon while at the same time keeps you from it improves your hand-to-hand skill, so. Skeletal warrior. You have been a pleasure to fight. I'll just move this into my inventory as well. And then just gonna go ahead and rest here. I suppose this is a safe space for you to rest. No shaman here, rather. I wonder where the shaman could be. Now, the important thing in Daggerfall, from what I've learned, is that you need to literally go into every nook and cranny, or at least when you go into a room, you need to look around properly, because if you don't pay attention to like the smallest portion of the map, it's very easy that you'll completely miss your prey or your objective. It can be like hidden inside crates and whatnot. So yeah, it's like pretty important for you to completely explore every single area of the dungeon that you're in before you decide to move on ahead. Now, as it is, I'm getting turned around here. I see something here. Something shiny. I take this as... oh, okay. So this brought me around all the way to the entrance. I can go deeper, or I can... actually, you know what? Let me just go ahead and dump the stuff that I got into the wagon since I'm near the entrance. Clear up some inventory space for myself. Yes, thank you. I would like to keep this in my wagon. Yes. This. Thank you so much. I should be feeling lighter now. Yes, I am. Thank you very much. I'm just gonna go ahead and save the game here then. And as you can see, I'm already turned around in this game right now, as things stand. So yeah, I mean, it's pretty imperative that you try your best to explore as much of the dungeon as you can before you decide to head on to bigger and better things. Like, look at this place here. I don't even know where to begin with this. Let's use with it. At this point, I've got two dilemmas. I don't want to explore this place right now. What I want to do is that I'm going to go back and I'm going to explore that one place that I did not explore. Should I go up here? Look, I'm already into it now, so I don't even know where to go anymore. This was. Okay, where did I come from? I think it was this place. Yeah, there was like this fork in the road, in the tunnel. And I just want to go back there. Yeah, I'm gonna go down here first before I go elsewhere. This apparently leads nowhere, so that is good. One less thing to worry about. Let me just open up the map and check where else I could have missed a few folks like that. Apparently, there's some place over here as well that I could have gone. So let me just go ahead and cover those areas first before venturing out to newer areas. Let's take a ride here and see what these ruins have to offer us. I got hit pretty hard there. That is a beautiful breastplate. Didn't realize you were a man. Took you for a soldier. My apologies. I did not mean to offend, but you are offended anyway. So, okay, these are... one thing I'll say about this place is that I like the fact that it's got plentiful loot. I've never found so much loot in any other castle, or room, or dungeon rather, before this, so yeah, this is definitely something that's refreshing for a change. Do I want to? Have I been here? Yeah, I think I have, yes. Let me just go ahead and take a ride at this juncture. Yeah, a light seems right. No, actually, I'm gonna go up. Hi, bear. These guys don't have any loot, otherwise I would try to loot them as well. Spoils of war. So this skeleton tells me that I've been here as well. And I suppose I'm making a very complete circuit at this point. And I suppose this is the point where I turn tail and go back to the one place that I haven't explored yet. I have explored all of these areas. Don't know why I did that, but these areas seem to have been explored. Yeah, I didn't mean to completely erase this area from the map, but whatever. I'll just walk here again and remind the map that hey, I already know this place. So yeah, we go back and we head downstairs this time out. I can hear an orc as well. I don't know where that orc is, but I can hear it. I don't think I've been here before. Let me just take the left, path on the left. All I really want to do is just kill this rabbit. That's it. Nothing else. But thus far, this place seems like a pretty easy... So another trick that I learned is that you can literally drop like a piece of gold on the ground to keep track of where you've been and where you've not been, and I think I'll try that out this time around. Yeah, let me just go ahead and drop like a piece of gold here. Golding miscellaneous? Nah, I just want to drop like one piece of gold here. Where is it though? I have a feeling I've already been here. Yes, I have. Yes, I have. Well then. So that's that. Oh, this is like an entirely circular route, right. I literally came down from there. So I'll just go ahead and drop my piece of gold right here. I suppose. Gold. How many pieces do you wish to drop? Just one piece. I hope that will mark the way for me, because I don't see any gold pieces here. That concerns me. I just wasted two gold pieces. Nothing good came out of it. I could go in here. Does it have to be like 5 gold pieces? There are enemies nearby. That's interesting to know. I was getting concerned that I'm heading the wrong way, the wrong direction. Although, I mean, there will be enemies nearby available in this game, as far as this game is concerned. Anyway. This part takes me back up again. Oh, okay. This is the path where. Yeah. It's that place. Can you please see us? And I think there's like this one section here that I've left unexplored. Going down here? I mean. Yes. Yeah, let's go down here. Let's check what this place has to offer. For the range, of course. Dodging is improved, stealth is improved, critical strike is improved. I wonder why all these skills are improved. Well, did I come out someplace that I've already been? I think so, yes. place was a dead end. This place. I wonder what this green object here is. I can see this one place here that we have not visited yet. Maybe we can go there and start trying to start looking again. Yeah, this is the very starting of the dungeon. Maybe we put something in the wagon as well, for whatever I have right now. That one place that I hadn't been to yet, which was it? So I think it's somewhere over here. No, it's in the next one, yeah. I'm supposed to go here. I'll take this left. And I don't know why the game is lagging here all of a sudden. Just my PC problem. Well, I'm gonna have to request you guys to kind of bear with it, because there's no real other way to, you know, tackle this issue. I can't exactly do anything about it. Boom, this giant. Wait, did I just get mithril boots? Awesome. Yeah. Like I tell you, giants have like some of the best loot out there. Is that like something for me to use? Apparently not. I can also get some orcs. I just wish I could like pick up some orcish as well. Orc sergeant died. But I still haven't found the bugger that I was looking for. Another boots, form of cloak. I'm sort of tempted to take that form of cloak actually. Yeah, I'll keep it with me. I'll keep those form of cloaks with me. That form of cloak with me. I don't know what you want. This guy suffered a very cruel fate. I wish that fate upon no one. Being imprisoned like that. And rotting to your death, literally rotting. But on the other hand, my character looks super fashionable, so there's that. I suppose I'm going somewhere I haven't been before. Ooh, two of you guys. This is gonna be fun. Yeah. Look at you. Sorry, then my dog decided to start barking on the sofa. Yeah, the place that I'm living right now, it's like super noisy and there's like a lot of, well, basically just noise all around without any reason. So, yeah. My dog gets bothered from time to time. And so do I. Like, especially at times like these when I'm recording. And there are people out there blasting away, you know, on their barrels, so literally just stopping their hearts to their heart's content. Which is nice, which would be nice, but I would rather like some peace and quiet for me to record properly. Problem with these series is that there's literally very little scope for any semblance of privacy, really. I think this is the base. Curious. Yes, I have been down there. Maybe I have not been somewhere over here. But we can go check, obviously. We can always go check. Let's see. Since we have not found the shaman yet, probably somewhere here that we need to go. I have been up here as well, apparently, and it does not lead anywhere. Except for this place here. Yet to see the shaman. I wonder where the shaman fellow is. Okay, this seems to be some place we haven't gone here, so we might as well go ahead and try to explore that. Okay. This takes us to a pointless area. Nothing there. Okay. And yeah, I'm on the tour with all the pointless areas. I just hope there's nothing here. Or if there is, there's some of the other method to access it, because yeah, I can't access it in that area. I mean, this area also has nothing. This I think is the way to go down, so that is what I'm going to follow them. Because apparently I've also explored this area. And this one, yes. So just go back and start exploring this area and stuff then. Because there's nothing here that's worth exploring anymore. I came up from here. Time to go back down. Now, where have we not visited here? Is the question. We have not completely visited that road on the right. Unless it was just like a short haul. Yes, it is. It is just a short haul. Nothing here. I can hear giants here, but I can't see them. Not that that's anything concerning, but I would rather like to be able to, you know, where to go. So, yeah. Anywhere here that we have not visited yet? This seems to be the only place left. This area, maybe. This area, mayhaps. Okay, let's keep going straight then, I suppose. Oh, wait. I think I'm supposed to take a right here. Right. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm supposed to take a right here. Oh, it's that place. Yeah, the place where I found nothing. I guess if we're gonna have to do it, then might as well get it over with. I'm thinking of replaying this game at least twice, once as a battle mage and the other time as, well, as a thief or an assassin. Going through water walking. Yeah, I would rather take the potion of water walking. Excuse me? My health should not be declining when water walking. Levitation, free action, healing, resist poison, healing, resist poison, levitation, water walking, purification, resist poison, water breathing. Hopefully this will help me not running out of breath, thank you. I have no idea what those things are. But I'm pretty sure that, okay, those are drugs. Again, I have no idea what those things are. But at least, I'm quite certain that these are not the things that I'm looking for. And look at this, Lord Chap. It's a zombie. Is there an attack button zombie in here? I wonder how long the effects of the water walking spell last. Not long, and apparently we didn't need it for long either. Like, if it wasn't for the battle, we probably would have survived this encounter. Okay. Time to let me just refer to the map once, and we'll be out of here afterwards. Yeah, there's nothing there. No windows or anything. None that I can see anyway. Okay. Nothing there either. Nothing there inside the water either. So yeah, the water walking did actually help, but I didn't need to pair it up with water breathing because otherwise I sort of float in the air without achieving much. So this path will take me back somewhere? Somewhere that I want to go perhaps? Because it seemed like this way is something that I've not explored. So what I'll do is I'll keep going straight and turn right at the dead end. Not the dead end rather, but maybe the point. And check out this area then. So yeah, that's what I was talking about. Like, if you're in heavy armor, this game is gonna like drown you without mercy. I suppose I can probably keep some things back into the wagon. And this. Huh. Thank you very much for your business. I expected the underwater area to be longer, but I suppose that was my bad. Yeah, we haven't been down here yet. This is my only hope of finding a... Oh, great. It's another underwater area. Water walking. Sure. Potion of water breathing, maybe? Oh no. I don't have potions of water breathing. What will I do now? Nothing apparently. Let me just go ahead and save the game. And an emergency save slot in case I'm unable to make it to the end. Excuse me, I do not want to climb. No. What are we doing? No. So I found out how the game is bugged in one of the ways, and I'm trying to figure out how I can make this guy go down. I think I'm gonna have to use these two keys here. Yep. Okay, I need to go back for a breath of bulky fresh air. Thank you. Okay, again. Anybody here? Nobody. Oh, that is close. I mean, nothing. I didn't find a shaman there, but yeah, that was close. I need more spells of water breathing. Otherwise, I mean, a lot of the areas of map become inaccessible. And as it turns out, the dungeon can actually sometimes hide your objective, you know, in these hard to reach areas. So yeah, water breathing becomes super essential in these cases. And is there any other place in this dungeon that I have not explored yet? I wonder. No, actually, I came through here and I went upstairs, didn't I? So how about I go downstairs instead? I'm pretty sure there were a few areas which were leading downstairs, but I did not want to go down at that point in time. This is again going upstairs. I think I saw a few areas like that. I'm not certain there, but I can hear monsters here, but I don't know how to access that chamber. Nothing. See, the game also likes to give you false hope like that by telling you, oh, you're too far away to interact, but when you try interacting, nothing happens either way. Huh. I'll just rest here. This is one of the areas where I could have gone, but didn't go yet. Is this an interactable? No, it's not. Oh yeah, it's that place, okay. And this is that place. The place of no consequence. Nothing in here either. I wonder, did I go up through this route before? Or was it another route entirely? Oh yeah, I did recently go through the chute as well. I did, yes. I'm just gonna run now for the sake of saving some time. It's sort of beginning to bug me how I'm unable to find some place that I have not visited yet. I think I chose this part the first time around, and yet I've led to no consequence. I think I have not taken this path yet. I have. Yeah, it's the same, it's a bit apart. Nothing new here. What about these areas? Have I missed? Oh yeah! Apparently I have. Apparently I didn't anything going down here, down this route. I don't know what that sound was, but I got excited for a second. I thought those were ebony. Dark rib. Now, these guys asked me to go and go down into another water piece area. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to go there. I think we haven't been here. I think we have already been here. Yeah. I mean, this was like the entire pointlessly long staircase that led to the top floor. I like this room. I did not attack it. But anyway, regardless, I'll still go down and check what we can do and what we can't do. Inventory, I'm just going to drop 5 gold, but hopefully that'll, you know, create... No? So, how much gold do I need to drop in one go? For there to actually become a pile on the ground. That's not working. We've already covered all these spaces, but I'm yet to find the shaman, and I have to wonder just where do I have to go to find this book? Maybe follow some of the paths I previously followed. Again, just for the sake of clarity, maybe. Because aside from that door which won't open, which I can't even interact with, I can't even think of anything else. Have you been down here? Apparently they have. Maybe we go this way. I do believe I've covered almost all of the dungeon, if not all of it, and I'm yet to find where this guy is. So, yeah. Daggerfall dungeons do be like that. Labyrinthine and combined with an affinity for hiding things in the most inconvenient of places. No shaman here. I think this was one of the earlier areas in the dungeon that we had covered. Did we cover this area? I think so. Let's go down. I don't know. Let's check. Yeah, I think we came crawling up through this area. Yeah, we did. We came crawling up through this area. Now, where do we want to go next is the question. Maybe we keep going up then. I don't know. Maybe there's some area that we neglected to explore before. Maybe we do have. It's just that whenever I enter that room, I always hear giants and other creatures, but I always fail to notice them. I can't see them at all. Which makes me wonder just what's going on with them. And why can't I see anything with the once I'm inside, I mean. I think it came out in that area. Over there? Yes, I did. Yes, I did. That area ends in A. What does it do? I forgot. This is the wall that has been blocking this one wall. And I would love to figure out what that wall is, actually. I think I've not visited that area. Let's go ahead and check. I'm pretty sure there's a wall there, but let's go ahead and check nonetheless. These areas I'm familiar with. I'm pretty sure I'll go familiar with the rest of the areas with time as well. But is there anything in here that I need to touch? Maybe some wall in here that is enchanted, or that is a door of sorts. Just try swinging for a while. Maybe it will open on its own. Who knows? I'll just go and put this axe for now and just rely on my fist. But apparently, I'm just missing. I'm not hitting anything. I'll just use this briefly to boost my shot these skills. This does not do much damage, but yeah, I mean, it's just one of the requirements of the game. If you want to boost your skills, you need to, well, do stuff. Yeah, I don't think we've been down here. I don't want to, like, change the levels. And oh yeah, there you are. That was quick. So yeah, I guess there was some area after all that we had not visited previously. Like, I guess double checking or triple checking your areas always helps. I get new giants. So that is a grim sight indeed. And the sound is again glitching up, so siege that I'm supposed to be targeting. Yeah, I took everything with that. Every single thing. Oh, hi there! So, yeah, some progress again, at last, finally. I'll just save the game here. And I do believe we're at a crossroads here, we can go up from there, we can keep cutting up here. I'll just check this area first. Okay, skeleton board, calm down. Now, the thing is, the thing that I have in my hand is called an ebony blade. It can, like, do damage to a wide variety of things. And so yeah, I don't really need to fear much of what comes my way. So basically, I can go down there. I don't know if I want to or not, but I can go down there apparently. Do I need to touch the skull or something? No, I guess it's just a warning that this will kill you. I can see something down there, but I don't know what it is. I can see like a pile of bones here. Mayhaps pointing me in the right direction. But unfortunately, it's time for me today and I cannot play any longer, so I will see you guys when I come back. This will be like just a brief cut for you guys, so yeah, see you later. Alright, we're back. And let's continue with our adventure. I suppose this is the way I was going. I think. Yeah, it was. Alright, let's continue our exploration. A whole different level here. Did the Nightblade like cast invisibility or something? That was like a pretty loud spell for something that was supposed to cast invisibility. I'm looking for better helms, because my helm is like +4, I'm looking for a +5 or maybe +6 helm, but this one I've been unable to find anything. Nobody here. I wonder if I should just close the distance and destroy it. I seem to be getting them. Yeah, they do seem to be using invisibility spells. Which is, strange. But I guess, well, yeah, enemies can also use spells in this game, so that's nice. That's nice for one thing. Just making a good luck save here. Nothing else. Nothing too serious about it. Or the reason I'm saving. Okay, let's try going up. Hopefully we'll remember how to get back here, if needed. Because I'm already quite turned around as it is. Anybody here? Over? Does this room have any doors? Does not seem to be the case. I like how the secret doors and stuff can actually show up on the maps. And sometimes they're also in like middle of these random corridors, so... never really know if they're gonna show up at all or not. I thought I saw somebody down there. A pit for the night blade route. And that is a tunnel down. I'm gonna check out that door first. Cool. Jumping and everything is like a little difficult in this game. Requires a little bit of skill. Okay, another pit down here. I'm thinking we probably need to use that to get down there. Tongs as well for presumably torture. Right now I'm just using the bandor that I have, ebony bandor. I got it off, I think I got it as loot from one of my previous dungeon raids, and I'm just using it right now in order to, well, just. Increase my short blade. Well, this does nothing. Does the other one do anything? No, this is the only one here. So I'm guessing this we're not supposed to go down there, right? Because typically, if you're supposed to go down there, it will give you like levity spell. Now, to go down here. I wonder. Oh, it just brings me up the other way. Fine. Actually, do I need to go here? I don't think I need to. I can just probably like go back the same way I came. Yeah. I think this would be a shorter route. There are also skulls here. I don't know why there are skulls here. I can see something down there, but I don't know whether I'm supposed to go there or not. If all else fails and I fail to find my objective, maybe I will consider going down there to, you know, get my objective. This way or that way? This way. We'll go this way first. But random coffin in the middle of nowhere. I don't know where that thing goes either. Oh, this actually has a switch here. That's interesting. We will go down there later. For now, or you know what? Let's just bring this thing up. Are you coming? Yes. Just for the sake of convenience, so that we don't have to jump the path. We can just walk over it. I wonder if that other room also had like a switch like that. I just want to go and verify quickly. Yeah, the familiar dungeon module, which typically has nothing in it really. I'll go down this route later. But first I'm gonna go back up there and confirm whether it did in fact have a switch or not. Yeah, okay. I guess I don't need to run right now, because I am aiming to preserve my stamina. Is there like a hidden door here or something? No? I don't know, something about the way the pixels are set sort of made me think that. Thus far, this new area seems to be mostly empty, and I sort of appreciate that about this dungeon. Like, most of the area is empty. But what I dislike is the fact that there's a damn night plate on there. What was my quest again? Orc Shaman? It's basically looking for an orc, right? Or is this the orc that I'm looking for? I wonder. Of course I can't hit them from here. Maybe I'll try equipping my bow and arrow. Now I am using a short bow right now. Come on. Yeah, that was just regular night blade, not really the orc shaman that I had to kill, otherwise I'm pretty sure notification would have popped up by now. Now back to... oh yeah, that's a dagger apparently, not even... a short bow of sorts. Not short bow, sorry. Did I check this room for hidden doors? I think I did. I don't know where this goes, but but I do not see a mechanism to trigger it either. Maybe one of these chains, maybe it has a lift down there somewhere. For a game made in 1996, they sure did put a lot of attention to detail in this game, and it was actually supposed to be far bigger than it is right now. And I just want to see how the game would have felt if they had, in fact, established, or rather, made it to the full scale of their vision. It's been a curiosity of mine for, as long as I've been playing this game, which is not long at this point in time, just 16 hours, but yeah. I guess this is the only way to go then. Unless we have to... Oh yeah, the elevator is also there, which will also lead us somewhere. This room is also an empty room, nothing here. I guess we first go down the elevator and then we check. There's also something down here, I don't know how to access it though. So yeah, right now we've got two paths to go. This is one of them. The other is the elevator, and then there's the dead drop floor here. Like somewhere above here. I don't know how. Yeah, I mean, this is also an area, isn't it? This also does seem to lead somewhere. Could this be the old channel that I'm looking for? Yes, this was the auction. So I actually left out there. I didn't expect the auction to be here, but thank God. Now I can keep climbing up, but that is rather futile at this point, since I have already killed the auction. I was sort of worried there that I might have to, use a health potion, because that guy really drove me to get a very, small amount of health. This was like a very lucky guess, to be honest, and I'm glad it paid off. I'm just gonna save here. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and save in the emergency save. Although this is not the save that I would typically like to use for this, but Whatever works, right? Whatever floats your boat. Now to figure out how to get out of here. I'm pretty sure I came from... No, this was not the way I came in. This is the Grim Suicide Room. Which way do I go now? I guess I keep following this route here? It's... no. Oh yeah, this route. We keep going this way, right. Just goes to show how whenever you think you've explored adventure to its maximum, you actually haven't explored much at all. I think the way out was this one right here. This one should probably lead us to the exit. This left here. I mean, the end of the road. The end of the road. I can still hear some monsters, but I got my objective that I came for. So I'm not really concerned about any other beings that could be here at this point in time. And from here, where do we go now? That would be a very good question. So... we keep following this road, I guess, and then there. Confusing indeed. Maybe if I zoom down a little and blur some of the, excess places that where I'm not present, but there are. Right. So, to go further down, what I need to do is, that is a very long winded road, and also not what seems to be the correct path. I think this is the way to the exit. Seems to be. I think so. I'm not sure. that should be the exit, so wait a while. Okay, so I just take a left, and yeah, it should be right in front of me. Yeah, right here. Awesome! So, let's... That was fruitful, yes. Fruitful indeed. Now, let me just go and save the game here again, because I'm like a sort of freaky that way, I like to save. And I'm not gonna just unsheat my weapon here, but what I will do is I'll equip this bracer, and I will open up the back end, and maybe just remove this to the back end as well. Seeing as how I don't really have much use for it right now. I just wish I got some better gauntlets as well. And some armor for my left side on top. Anyway, yeah, my characters will look pretty decked out. Pretty decked out, pretty nice actually. But apart from that, what else? Clothing and miscellaneous, maybe? I might like to put this on. Nah. This actually looks nice, I'm gonna leave it like this actually. For a change. I mean, puts all of her, you know, features on display. That's just a bracer. Cloth amulet. Yeah, just to, you know, keep that area occupied. That's all that I really want to do. Now to look, let go. At Victor Yeoming. Palace in Tumont. Right. So, yeah. Sorry, I'm a little slow right now. But, okay. Did I read that wrong? Am I spelling it wrong? Dunmont, no wonder. Dunmont, not Tumont. That's my bad. Well, since the travel time is the same, I guess we can go. I'll get on my high horse now, since I have a horse. Now to locate the palace. Yeah. I sometimes have to think where things are in this game. Dunmont is a huge place, I did not think Wayrest would have another huge city like this, with a palace at that. So thus far I can't really see, this looks like it might be the palace. So I can either keep going directly east, or there is also something up north. I think this is more of a temple though, so yeah, probably directly east. Okay. Let's put this information board. Boy there! Four horse comes through. Beware, human. That looks palacy. Palatial, I mean. Yep, this is the palace. Time to get off my high horse because I'm going to greet nobles. The palace. Where am I supposed to go here? Am I supposed to like climb? I hope I'm not intruding on anybody's privacy during this. I don't know why the game is lagging so much, but yeah, Ed Victor Yeoming. Are you Ed Victor Yeoming? Can I pass, please? No? Ah, thank you, finally. You are it, Victor Yeoman, so... Greetings to you, Grimfangs. First rate job with that stinking rancid shaman. How dare they set up one of their cannibal temples in my land. The leaderless rabble should be easier to deal with now. Here's your 565 gold pieces. Go wild. Seems like a pretty chill guy, actually. Go wild. Thank you so much, Your Majesty.
Oh no. Oh no. Okay. What do I remove from the wagon now? Can I put my horse in the wagon? Apparently not. Magic items. Weapons and armor. Jeez, this is difficult. This is like a pretty difficult choice. I think I'm just gonna remove the battle axe for now. So that I can like Yeah, so that I can just get these. I found 506 gold pieces in the Polite King's hand. Not that he rewarded me with 565 gold pieces. I found it in the King's hand. I'll be down, I presume. And... I can only assume this is the way out? No, I'm going the opposite way, of course I am. God damn, why do they have to make these palaces so confusing? And where to from here? I think the exit should be right here. Yeah. Now this is an example of a building that is as big on the inside as it is on the outside. I mean, there's no structural changes whatsoever from as far as I could tell on the map. But yeah, that's it for today. I don't know how long this video is going to be since I haven't sat to editing it. I just wanted to complete this first before I sat to editing it. And yeah, I booted up the game and I think I got the objective in like 15 minutes. But the actual exploration of the dungeon itself took quite a long time. So maybe, like I'll split it into different segments. I honestly don't know yet. But yeah, because otherwise it will probably be a little too long for one video. Plus, we also have this one main quest, optional main quest that we, you know, sort of, completed that we would be, you know, merging into this side quest of sorts. Even though this was an entertaining side quest, but still. At any rate, I suppose that is it for today. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around. I'll continue currying favor with Wayrest for the next few videos, or maybe, you know, like the next few missions. Until then, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow things.